Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, I'm Helda Oktaviani. My student number is 3233190011. In here, I would like to presentation about refusal strategy performed by Indonesian EFL learners. The research investigates the speech and coordination of refusing as made by Indonesian learners of English as a foreign language, native Indonesian and native English. It includes three groups. Number 1, 13 Indonesian EFL learners. Number 2, 13 Indonesian native speakers. Number 3, 13 American native speakers of English. They were asked to respond to 10 different situations in which they carry out the speech act of refusal. Their strategy is refusing well compared to one another in order to find out whether the refusal performed by Indonesian EFL learners correspond more closely with those of the Indonesian native speakers or with speakers of the target language, the American native speakers. The data collected from a discourse completion test result indicate that although a similar range of refusal strategies were available to the two language groups, cross-cultural variations still exist. The data involves some contextual variables, which include the status of interlocutors, higher, equal, or lower status. An utterance that needs an act is called speak act. Speak act is performed to receive a response from the hearer, but sometimes speaker fails to gain the referred response from the hearer. It happens when the hearer don't realize of what the speaker intention. For example, when you ask someone to accompany you to the market and she refuses to go with you by saying, "Sorry, I can't go with you." The utterance is called refusal. Refusal and rejection can be defined as a disapproval of the speaker's intention. The speak act of refusal occurs when a speaker directly or indirectly says no. When someone refuses to do something that the speakers expect, it means the speaker does not have a successful interaction. Based on the data, Indonesian EFL learners tend to use their native culture in refusing requests, offer, invitation, and suggestion. The most different strategy used among the three groups are directly say no and put the blame on the third party. Most native speakers easily say no directly when they want to refuse compared to Indonesian native speakers. Furthermore, most Indonesian native speakers use the strategy of putting the blame on the third party, which is rarely used by native speakers. It means that Indonesia EFL learners are still influenced more by their native language and culture rather than their target language. That's all for me. Thank you for your attention. And the last essay, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.